Audio Jungle.
I think on the sustainability of the environment, I think it's very important that actually a lot of, you know, the news that are going around about that plastic has been the cause of the environment, it's actually, you cannot blame it on the plastic. Actually, you should blame it on the consumer, you know, or on us for not, for being littering, you know. So I think the important aspect here is not to litter. If everybody can take that extra effort to actually don't throw your, once you finish consuming your final product, don't go and throw it down the river or down the drain and all that. Can you just, like in your area where you have segregation of waste and all that, put it in the right bin, you know, and then that will be taken away, and then this will then can be recycled. So incorporate the 3R concept to your mind to know that, to learn how to recycle, reduce and reuse it, you know. Research actually have found that plastic packaging is still the most economical and most efficient functional kind of packaging compared with all the other alternatives. Let's say you talk about glass, you talk about aluminum, you talk about a paper carton and all that. They found that plastic packaging has the lowest environmental footprint in terms of energy usage, in terms of water usage, in terms of greenhouse gas emission. So if you look at the climate change issue and environmental footprint, then plastic is still the best alternative. It's the best packaging to use rather than all the other alternatives. I hope that the organization, NGO, will actually be able to come out, you know, and educate the public about littering. And I think this is the most, why you look at marine littering, you know, actually it's really that, like, it's not the plastic issue, it's just that if people start collecting them, you know, there's a value for it now. There's a lot of demand now for recycled PET. You know, people are collecting it and they're making it into a new PET bottle. You know, PET raising to make new bottle. It is what they call a recycled packaging. It's not a single use. Or what they say, it's not actually single use. It's actually reuse and reuse again and again. And that is the trend that's going on towards. You know, so I hope the public will recognize that. You know, that do not litter. You know, we are taking effort in terms of reducing carbon emission by even using our solar panel to heat up our factory. We have been planting out of 330 acres of land. We have been planting, 15,000 over trees already. You know, to hopefully to also mitigate the reduce our carbon footprint, and also in other, like even in our plant, high technology to reduce our bottled water, you know, the packaging, you know, we reduce it by 30% through technology advancement. So we are able to actually come up with plastic bottles that are lighter weight, lightweighted, so that you save on the plastic usage. And also in terms of efficiency, running the plant with less reject, you know, and less energy being used. So these are all, we have been incorporating it, and we have recently also invested in a automated AI industry 4.0 warehousing, where we are using mobile robots, you know, to do all the kind of mechanism for running the plant. So these are all efforts that we have been putting in to ensure that we want sustainability. We want to go with the trend. You know, we want to go with what the system is leading to. So Industry 4.0, AI, and all these are incorporated into our factory, going forward, to compete with the market, to ensure that we are a responsible company, wanting the best for the consumer, wanting the best for the environment. The aquifer, what you call the water, underground water source, the sustainability of it is very important, very crucial. It's our crucial priority to ensure that this aquifer is sustainable. So therefore, we take a lot of effort to ensure that that we don't over pump the water. That means we control the pumping rate, okay? And then also we ensure that the aquifer is well, the environment is well protected, so that we can produce consistency, good quality water. For our aquifer here is about more than over 400 story building, 420 over feet deep now. And this is how mineral water has been formed. As I said, when rain kind of drops on the earth's surface, it starts seeping through the porous rocks, start absorbing the minerals in the rock, and then it keep on travel down more and more until it hit a non-permeable layers of rock, solid rock, and that was when it settled down and formed a big underground aquifer. And that's where we then pump it out as natural mineral water. So this is how natural mineral water actually is derived. And so you find that it's been well concealed, well protected. So in terms of quality wise, they are very sustainable. And we are fortunate that we are in Taiping. You know, we have the heaviest rainfall, you know, 4,000 millimeter per annum. Compared with other cities, we only have 2,000 millimeter per annum average. So we are very fortunate that our water source has keep on being refurbished, you know, if you like, keep on being refurbished through the rainwater that's coming in. We are now also concentrating on exporting our water, and because of the health benefit of this silicon-rich mineral water that we are able to come up with research, so that there's a lot of inquiry, you know, that I told you we are now exporting to UK, to China, and then even to Holland, and later on we're going to Spain and US eventually. There's a demand for this health benefit of the water. So we are looking, concentrating on export too. And then going forward, we'll also be coming out with some functional drinks, you know. Like here, we have this fiber drinks at here. So we are also looking to into diversifying into a lot of these type of functional drinks. And so hopefully we can then come up with a more variation of our spritzer water, using spritzer mineral water as the base.
Saya pakai spritzer semasa sejak saya kecil. Kita perempuan lagi. Saya dah kalau keluar, travel dengan family, family akan beli spritzer yang besar. Saya semua anything yang available, kalau macam pergi dekat petrol pump ke apa, yang mana-mana available, saya akan beli lah. Kalau iPad tu kita tahu kat rakyat ke apa kan. Macam kalau instead tu, macam kalau like kalau mall dia cerita lah. Tapi kalau macam saya cross handle ke apa ke, saya akan bawa satu kalau suka ke, ataupun kalau pergi camping nak masak ke apa.
So saya rasa ini cukup melambangkan sesuatu yang natural dan semula jadi. Audio Jungle.